All right, it's Crazy Ride here. We've got Nick Dukes, also known as in his feature matches at YCS Dallas, Alexander Dukes. He wound up making top 16 at YCS Dallas with his Insector build. And we're going to do a deck profile here. So let's go ahead and get into the deck.
Well, I'm going to start off with my side deck. I sided two Snowman Eaters, two Cyber Dragons, two DD Crows, one Effect Veiler, one Banisher of the Radiance, one Doom Caliber Knight, one Lightning Vortex, two War Decrees, one Malevolent Catastrophe, one Black Horn of Heaven, and one Divine Wrath.
Alright, so I'm noticing some randomness here. So with the Banisher Radiance, the Doom Cal, the Vortex, the Malevolent Catastrophe, and the Divine Wrath. Let's go ahead and get the story behind these cards here.
Well, Divine Wrath is for mirror match, wind-ups, and the Dino deck. It gives me an out to it, and it helps me take things out that's not favorable in those matchups. And this was purely for Hero. Destroy their back row, disrupt them. I mean, you get rid of Hero's back row, and they really can't really just do much. I mean, everything's predictable. So, and Vortex for Dino and Heroes again. I mean, because Hero and Dino is a bad matchup for Insectors off bat. Doom Cal, mirror match, and wind-ups. And it's actually pretty good against Dino, too. And this is just purely for mirror match and Dark Worlds.
And Dark Worlds. So I do got to ask this. How many mirror matches did you play?
I actually didn't play any.
No mirror match?
No.
What did you play the most of?
Mostly played Dino.
Dino?
Yeah, I went 4-0 against him.
That's what I like to hear.
Yep.
All right, let's go ahead and get into the main deck here.
Well, our main deck, the three best cards in Yu-Gi-Oh! Right now, in my opinion. BLS, Gores for bad players. Dark Arm for very bad players. But yeah, I run
we punish noobs with these cards right here.
Yeah, this punishes noobs like terribly bad. I mean, that's all I can say about that. I run one Gigamantis.
Alright, so what's the brokenness with Gigamantis here? So I know a lot of people seen the top 32 match.
Yeah, this card right here pretty much won me the game in my feature match. I played against Blake. What's his last name?
I think it was McCray.
McCray?
Yeah.
Something.
My bad if I mispronounced your name.
Yeah, and he actually beat himself the first game by heavy storming. But second game, I pulled it out again, and it did what it needed to do. I heavy stormed myself. He heavy stormed me. I heavy stormed myself. So, it is what it is. So, I won one of those. Three Dragonfly.
Staple.
Three Centipede. And three Hornet.
Basic Insector lineup.
Yeah, basic stuff. That's it for the Insectors. Two Effect Veilers. Three Rykos.
Alright, so this was the big deal here. What's going on with the Rykos?
Ryko is broken. Like, when Insectors, people's only out is like Effect Veiler. You know what I mean? If I get rid of your back row, I pretty much can just go into my combo and win the game. Like, pretty much every time. So I run three Ryko just to kill back row and to kill Lagia first turn. So it did what it needed to do.
Helps kind of get the setup for the chaos.
And it's a light for chaos too.
Gets the Mills the Hornet if you don't pull it.
Yeah. Right, there's a lot of things. one random Thunder King. Actually, I would take this card out and probably throw in another effect villain, but it did what it had to do. I mean, I hardly ever pulled it, but it was good. Run 3 Pot of Duality.
Why do you play Pot of Duality?
So I can get the consistency of this deck, and so I can get Gores, so I can punish Noobs. I'm just playing, but yeah, just consistency. I mean, it helps me get set up for the deck. You know what I mean?
So it's consistency.
I mean, it is what it is. I run 1 Dark Hole, 1 Book of Moon, 1 Monster Reborn, 1 Heavy Storm, 1 Allure of Darkness, 1 Foolish Barrow, 3 Mystic Space Typhoons.
Alright, now onto the trap lineup.
2 Fiendish Chains, 2 Torrential Tributes, 2 Solemn Warnings and Solemn Judgment, 1 Call, 1 Phoenix Wing Blast, and 1 Dust Tornado.
Alright, so let's get into this right here. Alright, so let's go in depth on the Dust Tornado and the Phoenix Wing Blast.
Mm. Well, Dust Tornado, I mean, like I said, they have very few outs for Zectors to go off into their combo. So, I mean, Dust Tornado killing their back row really helps me go into my combos and stuff. And with Wing Blast, it helps me if I need another Dark for Dark Arm, or if I need a Life for BLS, it helps me put one in the graveyard, and it helps me put one in their back row to the top, or it stops a play, like with Dinos. It stops when they go Rabbit. I could put one of they.
Oh, you?
I could put one of they Dinos on top of the deck and stop them from going into they Dokas and Laggy and things like that.
So
it worked out.
So that was nice tech there. And how did that work out with you?
What was that?
How did it work out for you? The Wing Blast.
The Wing Blast, it was okay. I mean, it helped me win a couple games. Like, I mean, I can't just say it just won me games, but it did okay.
Okay.
Going to my extra. 2 Chimera Tech. 2 Leviathan. 1 Zen Mane. 1 Acid. 1 Giga Brilliant. 1 Gachi Gachi. 1 Stardust. 1 Rose. 1 Army Arm, 1 Red Dragon Arch Fiend, 1 Dark End Dragon, and my MVP card of the day. I don't speak French, but I'm going to call this card right here Chevy. Chevy on the floor.
Okay, so why did you play this card?
I play this card to punish trash people running quick draw. I had to punish you. Like, I knew somebody was gonna play it too. I actually played a dude, Monster Born, his quick draw, and synced it with a Hornet, and actually killed him. Wins games.
This card wins games.
Wins games.
All right. So what's that token you got there?
Oh man, let me show you. This is
that guy looks kind of familiar.
This is my dude right here, Chris Bryant, man. He's my inspiration to play this game.
Even though he's been on hiatus for a little while.
Yeah, he's been out of the game for a while.
He's going to get a good welcome back whenever he...
He was actually chunking up the deuce to the librarian, because, I mean, all the plants is gone. Fat boy talking.
All right. Well, so that wraps it up for the deck profile here. You know, we're a team that's been around for a while. and it's time to do what we need to do in this game. So there was also some controversy that went on at the YCS with some events that happened. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Well, we'll go ahead and start another video and get your intake on what happened.